Good morning, class. Today we'll be studying about gyroscopic effect. But before going to gyroscopic effect, three things we must know are: number one, precession; number two, couple; number three, angular acceleration. So we will start with the precession. To understand what is precession, we will take an example. Suppose this is a rotor. This is a rotor rotating clockwise direction, looking from the left side. This is your view, with angular velocity omega at time t is equal to 0. So let us suppose this is the rotational axis of this rotor, which is lined with positive x-axis, and suppose this is your normal Cartesian system. In which this is x-axis, this is y-axis, and this is the origin. Now, first we have to find the direction of the angular velocity vector. How will we find the direction of angular velocity vector? The direction of angular velocity vector can be found with the help of right-hand thumb rule. What is the right-hand thumb rule? Right-hand thumb rule says, if we place our right hand in such a way that our thumb is perpendicular to our fingers, and we rotate our finger in the sense of the rotation of the rotating body, then our thumb will indicate the direction of angular velocity vector. So here in this case, we can see this was rotating in like this with omega at time t is equal to 0. So this will be the direction of this, its angular velocity vector. Suppose it is OA. So this is the right hand thumb rule. Now, if we rotate this rotational axis OA of this body with respect to some other axis, suppose Z axis, then this rotation of rotational axis of a rotating body with respect to some other axis is called nothing but precession. Suppose I have rotated this axis, suppose this is A dash, by angle d theta in xy plane. Okay? Suppose this rotation has taken place in time dt. So this is omega at the rate time is equal to dt. So the next question is, what is axis of precession? Axis of precession is the axis about which the rotational axis of any rotating body is being rotated. So here in this case, the axis of precession is Z axis. Second thing we have learned, precession. Third is axis of precession. In this case, it is Z axis. Now, fourth is, what is plane of precession? Plane of precession is nothing but the plane in which we are rotating the rotational axis of this rotating body. So, in this case, we can see that we are rotating this rotational axis in the XY plane. So, we can say that the plane of precession is the plane in which the rotational axis of a rotating body is being rotated. So, in this example, XY plane is plane of precession. Now, coming to velocity of precession. Number 5 is velocity of precession. What is velocity of precession? Velocity of precession is the angular velocity of rotation of the rotational axis about the axis of precession. It is the rotational axis of, it is the rotational speed of the rotational axis about the axis of precession. So, we can say that it will be equal to d theta by dt, as this rotation d theta was taking place in the time dt. We can represent this velocity of precession with omega p. So, this was velocity of precession. Now, two things we have to know more. Axis of precession, axis of spin, and plane of spin. What is the axis of spin? Axis of spin is just nothing but the rotational axis of body itself about which it is rotating with angular velocity omega. So it is, we can see here x-axis, it is also called rotational axis, and it is called plane of rotation. Here it is x-axis, and in this case the plane of rotation, we can see that this body is rotating in yz plane, the plane perpendicular to this board. So here we can say in this example yz plane. These all things I have written is specific to this particular example. These axes and planes may vary from example to example. So we should not think that this will be always like this only. Our next topic will be couple. We'll see what is couple. What is couple? Couple. As we know that when two equal opposite parallel forces separated by a distance r act on a body, they constitute a couple. So here are two forces, parallel forces separated by distance r, they will constitute a couple. We can say two equal opposite parallel forces separated by distance r. As we know that couple is a vector quantity, so it must be having two things. It is a vector quantity, vector. So it must be having two things. Number one is magnitude. Number two is direction. Okay? Magnitude. Magnitude we can find with the cross product of force vector and distance between them, which is nothing but Fr sine theta. But theta is the angle between this distance which we are measuring and the force. Now, direction. Direction of the coupled vector we can find also with right hand thumb rule. What right hand thumb rule says here? If we keep our right hand in such a way that our thumb is perpendicular to the fingers and we rotate our fingers in the sense of the couple, then our thumb will be indicating the direction of the couple vector. So in this case, this is my finger, I'm rotating in the sense of the couple. So this thumb is indicating the couple vector in this case, which is pointing outward from the board. Third thing we have to know, what is tendency of couple? Tendency is nothing but what couple wants to do. Suppose, for example, this is a couple acting in YZ plane and with the thumb rule we can find the axis of this couple. Suppose this OX and O dash X dash, which will be parallel to X axis, we can see with the right hand thumb rule. Now we have to find out what is the tendency of this couple. We can see that if we see from the right hand side, then we can see that this couple wants to turn this YZ plane in anti-clockwise direction. If we see from the right hand side, this couple wants to rotate the YZ plane in anti-clockwise direction. So this is the tendency of the couple. Next thing we have to know, what is, we have seen the axis of the couple, this is the axis of the couple, which can be found with the help of right hand thumb rule. Now we have to see what is plane of couple. Plane of couple. Plane of couple is the plane in which the force which are constituting the couple, the forces which are constituting the couple are acting. In this case, these forces are acting in YZ plane. So, plane of couple is the plane in which forces of couple are acting. In this case, YZ plane. Okay. So this was all about couple we should be knowing before proceeding to our next topic. Our next topic is angular acceleration. Angular acceleration. Acceleration. What is angular acceleration? Angular acceleration is nothing but the rate of change of angular velocity vector. So we can write that angular is rate of change of angular velocity vector. So, as we know that angular velocity is a vector, angular velocity. Is a vector. So it must be having two things, magnitude is equal to rate of change of angular displacement and direction. Here we can see that the angular acceleration is being generated due to change in the angular velocity vector. So, angular acceleration can be generated due to two reasons. Number one, change in magnitude of angular velocity. Second one, change in direction of angular velocity. So these are two reasons due to which angular acceleration can be generated. So we will proceed to our next topic, gyroscopic acceleration and gyroscopic couple, which is our main topic. So now we will see gyroscopic acceleration and gyroscopic couple. First, gyroscopic acceleration. Okay. As we have previously seen that gyroscopic acceleration is a type of angular acceleration, and as we have seen that angular acceleration can be due to two reasons. First was due to change in the magnitude of angular velocity, omega, and second reason is change in the direction of angular velocity. So we'll take an example. Suppose suppose in this case this rotor is being rotated by angle d theta, and also its angular magnitude of angular velocity is changing from omega to d omega, omega plus d omega. Okay, so in time dt, so we can see that there will be two components of angular acceleration. One, because of change in the direction of angular velocity, and second one, which will be due to change in the magnitude of angular velocity. So we can see here, if I project this xy plane in the plane of the board, so we can see here. This was your initial velocity vector, and this is your final velocity vector. So at time t is equal to 0, this one at time t equal to dt is d theta. D theta is small. Okay. Now we can see from this vector diagram, this will be change in angular velocity, which is net change. This is change in angular velocity in y direction, and this will be change in angular velocity in x direction. So if we want to find the angular acceleration in x direction and y direction, then we can write, suppose, angular acceleration in x direction. So we can see from this diagram, it will be equal to cos component of final velocity vector minus cos component of initial velocity vector by the time in which this change is taking place, that is gt. So as d theta is small, so cos d theta we can write as 1. So it will be 1 omega d omega dot 1 minus omega dt. This will be cancelled out and it will come equal to d omega by dt. We can see that this component is coming due because of change in the magnitude of angular velocity. This is due to change in angular velocity velocity with respect to time. Okay. Now if we want to find out angular acceleration in y direction, so we can write vertical component of the final velocity vector and vertical component of the initial velocity vector, that is nothing but 0. Here also, if d theta is small, we can write sine d theta equal to d theta. So here we can write omega plus d omega d theta by dt. If we expand this, it will become omega d theta plus d omega d theta by dt. As we can see that it is a product of two very small quantities, so it will be even smaller. So we can neglect this, neglect very small, small. So we can write here omega d theta y dt. We can see that this component of acceleration is coming due to change in the direction of angular velocity from d theta by dt, due to change in direction of omega. Okay, so this is nothing but, we have seen, this is nothing but velocity of precession. So we can write it as, and this is nothing but known as gyroscopic acceleration denoted by alpha p. So it will be equal to alpha p, this whole thing. This is gyroscopic acceleration. Now if we want to write net acceleration in this case, alpha net vector will be x component, y component will be along y axis j. This will be net vector. If we talk about, this will be equal to talk about magnitude. Magnitude of this vector will be equal to so this is net acceleration. Now in next case we'll be supposing that our angular velocity vector is constant in magnitude, then we'll see what will happen. So next we'll assume this will be zero. Now I'm assuming, suppose omega is constant in magnitude, then d omega by dt will be 0, that is alpha x. So alpha net will be equal to alpha y j, that is gyroscopic acceleration. Okay, in that case this diagram will become gyroscopic acceleration. And the direction of gyroscopic acceleration, we can see with that diagram, will be direction. See, direction. Direction will be in the direction of, we can say it like this, direction will be perpendicular to rotational axis. Rotational axis of rotor and in sense of rotation. Sense of rotation. What it means? Means this is your rotational axis. It will be perpendicular to this rotational axis and will be in sense of rotation. Rotation is like this. So it will be like this. So this is your direction of gyroscopic acceleration. Suppose this is your gyroscopic acceleration alpha p. Now we know that by Newton's second law, by Newton's second law, if there is net angular acceleration on any body, then there must be some net couple acting on the body. Okay, so if there is net acceleration acting on a body, angular acceleration on a body, then there must be net couple will be acting on the body. So we can say this couple is that as active gyroscopic couple. So how to find the magnitude of active gyroscopic couple? Suppose I is the moment of inertia of rotor, then active gyroscopic couple will be I omega alpha p. It will be equal to I omega omega p. This will be your active gyroscopic couple. This active gyroscopic couple will be by system. Suppose us on rotor. What does it mean? Means this active gyroscopic couple will be applied by system, which can be us, who is trying to rotate the rotor by angle d theta in xy plane. So it is applied by system on the rotor. Okay, and what will be the direction? Direction will be along alpha p. That is, perpendicular to rotational axis in sense of rotation. This was active gyroscopic couple. If we talk about reactive gyroscopic couple, so by Newton's third law. Newton's third law says if there is an action Newton's third law says if there is an action, there will be an equal opposite reaction. So this rotor will be applying a resistive or reactive couple on the system. So we can say that reactive gyroscopic couple will be applied by rotor on system. The magnitude of this reactive gyroscopic couple will be equal to active gyroscopic couple which is nothing but I alpha p, which is I omega omega p, and the direction will be exactly opposite to active gyroscopic couple. So direction of reactive gyroscopic couple will be opposite to active gyroscopic couple. So we'll see here, this was the direction of gyroscopic acceleration. So as we have seen that the active gyroscopic couple will be directed along this gyroscopic acceleration, so this will be the direction of active gyroscopic couple and this will be direction of reactive gyroscopic couple. Here we can see that the active gyroscopic couple will be directed perpendicular to the rotational axis in sense of rotation, and reactive gyroscopic couple will be directed perpendicular to the rotational axis but in the opposite sense of rotation. So this is the sense of rotation, and reactive gyroscopic couple will be directed in opposite to the rotation, that will be like this. This is the reactive gyroscopic couple. One thing we must notice that it is the reactive gyroscopic couple we are most concerned because it is only the reactive gyroscopic couple which affect the stability of the different bodies in the different condition. Now if we see our previous Cartesian diagram, so we can see that this is our rotor. So we can see that this was your rotational axis at initial condition and this is the final condition. Here I am supposing omega is constant. Now if you want to identify the different plane and different axes, then we can say that first axis of precession, axis of precession here is z axis, about which the rotational axis of this rotor is being rotated. So here it is z axis, plane of precession, plane of precession is the plane in which the rotational axis of this rotor is being rotated. So it is xy plane. Now, axis of spin. Axis of spin is the axis about which this rotating body is itself rotating. So it is, in this case, x-axis. Plane of spin. We can see that this body is rotating in yz plane, parallel to yz plane. So yz plane will be plane of spin. Now, axis of couple. We have seen in our previous diagram, the couple was acting along y-axis. In previous diagram it was like this. This was your y-axis and couple was acting along this. This was active gyroscopic couple. So this will be, the axis of couple will be y-axis. Active gyroscopic couple will be acting in positive y direction and reactive gyroscopic couple will be acting in negative y direction. Okay. Now, plane of couple. If this is the axis of couple, the plane perpendicular to this axis will be plane of couple. So plane of couple will be plane perpendicular to axis of couple. So the plane perpendicular to the y axis will be zx plane. So plane of couple will be here z axis. Please note these axis and planes vary from example to example. So this is not something is fixed. So these all things are not something always fixed. With the example or with the case, these things will change. Suppose x-axis can also become the axis of precession, y-axis can also become the axis of precession. These things can change. But in this case, these all axis and plane are like that. Okay. Now, in our next lecture, we will see the effect of gyroscopic couple or reactive gyroscopic couple on the stability of the different body, such as rolling of shape, pitching of shape, and turning of four-wheeler. We'll see in our next lecture. Okay? Thank you, class.